Hello everyone, do you ever want to port forward to a service running inside your cluster, but you just can't remember the port number? Now, in this case, I'd like to port forward to Grafana. I'm not even sure this is the right service name, and I certainly don't remember the port. I just remember it's something weird, and it's not port 80. So fortunately, there's a tool that I discovered recently, which I absolutely love, and it's called Kpoof, and it makes this really easy, both if you don't remember the name of the service, and if you don't remember the port number. Kpoof is the easiest way I found to port forward into clusters. Before I show you it, let me just say that this is day 5 of 100 Kubernetes Tools, a series where I'm looking at one new tool a day, so be sure to subscribe on YouTube if that interests you. So without further ado, we run Kpoof, and the first thing it asks me is what cluster would you like to connect to? I'll press enter to use the default option, which is my current kubeconfig context. Asks me now what namespace, hit enter again. And now it asks me to choose the pod number. Let me pull that over to the side. And here I have a list of all the different pods in that cluster, in that namespace. And like I said, we want Grafana. So I'll just put in here 10 and we'll port forward to Grafana. Now this is going to look at Grafana and it's going to port forward to every single one of the ports that's exposed by that pod. So let's just wait for that to finish. I could have sworn that when I did this before the demo, it actually went faster. Okay, and I see here port 3000. Like I said, there's port 80 here, but that's definitely a trap. So I jump over here to the browser. Let's go over here. Let's change that to 3000. And just like that, I'm port forwarding into the cluster and I can access Grafana. If you're wondering why Grafana is exporting other ports here, the pod really is exporting these other ports. It's just not what you want when you want to browse to it in the browser. Now, let me talk briefly about how you install Kpoof. If you're on a Mac, it's the easiest install ever. You just run two commands, run this, and then I suggest you run this next. So you'll install Kpoof without installing kubectl because you probably already have kubectl. And that's really all there is to using Kpoof. Now, if you open Grafana often after you see alerts, then it would be really nice if there's a way that when you get an alert, for example, in Slack or MS Teams or some other place, you could just get the alert ready with the data that you actually want to see. So you wouldn't have to open up Grafana. You wouldn't have to run a bunch of kubectl commands. All the data would just be there in the Slack message or in whatever other messaging platform you use. So I actually work on an open source tool that lets you do that. Let me mention that really briefly here, and I'll go into that more in a future video. So that tool is called Robusta, and you can pull in all this different data. You can pull in graphs, you can run bash commands automatically on the pod and pull the output in. You can show for node alerts what pods are running on that node and more. So please check that out, and that will be the topic of a future video. As always, leave comments on YouTube. Tell me what you loved, tell me what you hated, and tell me how I can improve future videos. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.